Between baseball caps and jeans and a laid-back rehearsal at Orchestra Hall, members are busy practicing for a baseball-themed kids' concert. Though it's a much more serious piece of music that's bringing them worldwide attention this week.
It's the first in a series of Mahler symphonies that we have released.
An hour-long symphony recorded right here at Orchestra Hall is now Grammy nominated for Best Orchestral Performance, putting the Minnesota Orchestra once again on the world stage.
It is an endorsement of the quality of the orchestra. We consider ourselves, and I think rightfully so, as a great orchestra.
The nomination is actually the fourth here at the Minnesota Orchestra, and as you can see in this display case, they actually took home the trophy in 2014.
They're not the only ones getting Grammy attention this week. Their neighbors across the river were nominated for Best Chamber Performance.
It's really thrilling and it's a great honor.
The St. Paul Chamber Orchestra was nominated for its live recording of Death and the Maiden.
It's just a big part of what we do, bringing great music to this community that we love.
They too have Grammys in their past, but they haven't won one since 1980. Both orchestras are up against some stiff competition with four others in each of their categories. Win or lose, though, just being mentioned among the best, they say, is its own reward.
It's tangible evidence that all of the excitement and faith and confidence in this orchestra is well placed.
In Minneapolis, Gordon Severson, Care 11 News.